Hi, everyone. This is Alicia Katz-Pollock at Royalwise Solutions, and you can find us online at learn.royalwise.com. And today I'm really excited to share with you a feature that is coming to QuickBooks Online. They've started rolling it out, but you might not have it yet. I've been beta testing, and I'm really excited about it. This feature is the ability to email in your receipts from your phone and have it do OCR to classify your transactions on your behalf so that you no longer have to do it all manually. Let me show you how it works. Where you're going to find the feature is in the banking area. So if you head to banking, here you can see that I have two transactions waiting in my bank feed. And the new feature's up here under receipts. So I'll click on receipts and it takes me into the new interface. There's four different sections to pay attention to. One is the drag and drop area. The other is the email area. Then there's a processing area where it is running the OCR to scan the receipts for you. And then the ones that have been scanned and are waiting to be entered. There's two ways of getting all of your receipt images into your QuickBooks Online. And these can be JPEGs, they can be GIFs, they can be PDFs. One way is to simply drag and drop. So if I pull up an email that has a receipt attached to it, like this one right here, I can see that I have a PDF down at the bottom, and all I have to do is drag and drop the PDF, and that green plus sign is telling me that it's going to add that PDF to this window. Once it has uploaded, you're going to see it down in the processing area while it's running the OCR. You can also click on the box for browse to upload and then drill onto your computer and go find an image or a PDF that you want to add. The other way of sending in your receipts is by email. Take a look at this Manage Senders link in the upper right-hand corner. When I click on it, you can see a list of all of the users in your file. If the user is at least a standard user with rights to see the vendor permissions, then they can use this option. So you can turn on and off different people who you think might want to email in their receipts. If you need to add a new sender, this would actually take you to the Manage Users and you would create them an account on your QuickBooks Online. Let me just show you real quickly what that would look like so that you know that you have the right permissions. When I add a user using the green button in the upper right-hand corner, I would do a standard user right here. And then the option that they need is under limited, they need to at least have vendors. You may have them doing customers too, but if vendors is not turned on, they won't be able to email their receipts. I would continue and create this user, but I'm not going to right now. So I'll close it and go back to banking and to receipts. Once you have turned on their permissions, their email address is now associated with this one file. When they pull up their phone and they take pictures of their receipts, they can now email these receipts to receipts@quickbooks.com. And because their email address is mapped to this exact file, it knows to import the images into the file. And then it will scan it for attachments and start parsing the attachments. What's nice is you can have more than one image or more than one receipt in the email, and it will find them all and separate them out. Do note that this does bump up against a limitation. If you're a bookkeeper, you may not be able to use this yourself if you have more than one client, because in your QuickBooks Online for accountants, you've got one email address for all of your clients. So you yourself would only be able to email receipts to one person. If that's your issue, then you would just use the drag and drop files and drop them in that way. Once the emails have been parsed by the OCR, now it's time to classify them. There's two different workflows that you could use. One is to classify the transaction and put in the details here in the receipts area and then match it to your bank feed. Or you can match it to the bank or enter it in the bank feed and it will match it in the receipts area. There's certain reasons why you would choose one versus the other, and I'll show you what they are. I'm going to start by choosing this first receipt on my list. And it says here, no matches found, but I want to actually see how it got the information that it got. So I'm going to click on this edit receipt details, which will back it up a step. Do note that the information that you see here may not be completely accurate because it's working off of the same artificial intelligence that the bank feed works off of. And as we know, it tries to make assumptions and do best guesses for you. And so it might not be right the first time. The good news is that it does learn. Once I have classified this McMinniman's Chapel Pub receipt properly, the next time I have one, it will automatically fill in everything that I used before. And then I can just change anything that needs to be modified. So here, it did come up with the payee restaurant for me because it says pub. I don't put in all of my restaurant names as separate vendors because otherwise mine would be very cluttered because I take clients out or I go out to eat on a regular basis. So I just have one generic restaurant, but because my description has the restaurant name in it and I have the receipt, I've got the backup that I need and it's fine to use a generic vendor in this case. It did read the 1950 off of the receipt, so it knows which bank account to map to. It also read the date off of the receipt. And because it said pub, it knew to put it in meals and entertainment. Awesome. But what I do need to do here is make sure that I, in the description, write who I ate with and what we talked about to make sure that this is bombproof for the IRS. It pulled the amount. I would double check it and make sure your handwriting says the same thing. And then if you needed a memo, you have an additional place that you could put it right there as well. Now I'll click Save and Next. This is where it looks for potential matches in the system. It doesn't see one, so it's going to create a new expense for this receipt. And I'll go ahead and click the green button to create that expense. And it's off of this list. When I go back to banking in the upper left-hand corner, I can now see that it has one record found and it matched the bank feed for me. In fact, I can click on it and then click on the link for the expense and open up the expense. And this is the one that we just created just now with the information that we put into place with restaurant, meals and entertainment, my specific description, and look down at the bottom in the attachments box, here's the image. If I click on the image, I can see the receipt. So now I have my receipt backup right inside the transaction. I did say that sometimes that's the right workflow to use, but sometimes you need to go in the other way. If you noticed when we filled in the form in the receipts area, there was nowhere to assign a class, nowhere to assign a customer, nowhere to make it billable. So if you're doing job costing, you're not going to be able to go from receipts to bank feed, but you can go from bank feed to receipts. Let's take a look at that. This transaction that I have down here is our cleaning, and because I have a home office, the one receipt that she sends me is a mix of business and personal. So I would have to do that here in the bank feed and then match it to the receipt. You will notice that I do have a rule applied for dustbusters. And when I click on the edit split button down here in the bottom right-hand corner, it does bring up the splits that I had created in that rule. If you're not familiar with banking, the banking feed, and especially the banking rules, I have a great bank feeds course on my website at learn.royalwise.com that I think is required viewing for everybody. But take a look here, and you can see that I have classes assigned. And if I needed to assign this to a customer, I could. If I needed to mark it as billable, I could do that as well. So now I have everything that I need here for this transaction, and I'll save and add, which now takes it off of my banking feed. Here's that other transaction we did. I will go ahead and match that one too, and so that takes care of the bank feed side. Let's head back to receipts. And back in receipts, now, look at this. The Oregon Dustbusters now has one record found. It actually found the transaction that I had, it matched the image to the transaction. If I wanted to see it, I could go in and look at it. Here's the 225 receipt. Here's the 226 expense. So it was smart enough to now applied that attachment to the invoice. When I go ahead and click match, or not invoice, the expense. Now, when I go ahead and click match, if I go up here, I can go look at it. So I'm clicking in the search box, which gives me a list of my recent transactions. I'll click on expense. And now here is the split that I had just created. And sure enough, here is the PDF right here at the bottom for me. So it's that easy to do. This is the new receipts feature. If you have been having trouble with your employees not sending in their receipts on a timely basis and getting them to go in and use Expensify, this is just that much one step easier for your employees. Do note that it does mean that the receipt images are on their phone, so you will want to suggest to them in your workflow that after you have processed the receipt and you know that you have the image, that they go ahead and delete them off of their phone for security measures. If you are somebody who is paying for Expensify or Receipt Bank or HubDoc, those are much more robust platforms. And if you are using other features that make them worthwhile, then by all means, you should continue using them. But if all you were using it for was just receipt importing, you might not need it anymore because now it's free inside your QuickBooks Online. So hopefully you're as jazzed about this as I am. So again, my name is Alicia Katz Pollack. My website is learn.royalwise.com. If you enjoyed this video, I do weekly live classes and webinars, and I have an on-demand video library and even a QBO training mentorship program. So if I can be of service to you in learning to use QuickBooks Online effectively and efficiently, let me know how I can help. Take care. Bye-bye.